Hey guys! Today we're making another miniature project in a tin, this time a fairy garden or enchanted forest. Hope you'll enjoy! First you want to pick out the tin you want to use. You can use any tin that's similar to this one or any tin that you think would make a good fairy garden. Roll out a thin sheet of blue clay and place this inside the lid. Then smooth that out and cut off any excess. Trim down a popsicle stick or use a sheet of clay to make kind of like a shelf. Attach it using liquid clay and pre-bake. The next few things we're gonna make will be baked in the tin. So next you want to make a mushroom. I chose purple for mine, but you can use any color you want. I used a couple of silicone tools and a toothbrush to add some texture. If you want, you can add some shading to the top using purple pastel. And then you also want to add some white dots of clay. Place this inside the tin using a tiny bit of liquid clay, and then add some green clay for grass or moss. For this, I just added texture using a toothbrush. For the area where I wanted the pond, I added some grayish brown clay, and I added the same clay to the bottom of the shelf to make the floating island, which I'm sure you all know is a very normal find in an enchanted forest. And for the texture under the island, I used dotting tools and the toothbrush. Just for some extra detail, I also mixed some brown and some grey sand with liquid clay and added that. And if you don't have this, you can just dab on some paint. After pre-baking, you should have something like this. And I then added some black paint to the areas with the dirt. Next up, I just mixed some resin and poured this into the pond, and then once that had almost set, I used a toothpick to add some texture. I glued on preserved moss to make it look a bit more woodsy, and before adding this to the lid part, I did paint the background using acrylic paint. To make the leaves, flatten a piece of green clay, cut out the basic shape, add texture using a needle tool and toothbrush, then bend them and bake. And then after baking, you can glue them in place. I then made the tiny house, and for this I did pre-bake the sheet for the roof before adding it to the house itself. After pre-baking, I cut the holes for the door and window, then added the last details and baked again. Glue this in place, add some moss around it, and then add some more details using brown and black acrylic paint. Instead of making flowers, I glued on some purple craft sand, and I then added highlights to the leaves using green acrylic paint. Lastly, I added some purple and gold pigments, and I applied these by mixing them with glaze. And for a final touch, I just added a tiny bit of this flower soft, but if you don't have this, you can just paint the preserved moss. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.